passport bros are black men from America that can't get no bitches. So they go to third world countries and get
bitches. It's almost like you just don't want black women to be happy. You don't want black women to find love elsewhere. You just don't want them to find love at all. Because why not just keep to yourself that you don't want to date black women and allow us to find love elsewhere?
So let me get this straight. So you socially awkward niggas is going overseas to disappoint bitches now?
What's really gonna happen is women are really gonna like literally start taking all of the advice that men are giving. Oh, choose better, stop having sex, don't talk to bums. Okay, so that would render 99% of y'all undateable, unhave sex with a bull. We would be rendered celibate and childless if we took the advice that y'all are giving us, because it's all of y'all. If we really listened to you and said, oh, we choose better, okay, so we're going to stop dealing with 99% of y'all, and then what? Y'all are going to be lonely, and then y'all are going to be mad, and then we're going to have to deal with the violent aftermath of a bunch of men walking around with quote-unquote blue balls, right?
Well, actually...
What's the deal, for?
Forbes!
All right, so I'm going to record this. It's called the Female Delusional Calculator. Now watch this. This is what I'm going to love. This is backed by the United States Census Bureau. It's factual data. Define a man of my dreams. So I'm going to plug this in here, okay? I'm going to go from the average age of 28 to 45. Any race, color, white, black, or Asian. The average height in the United States is 5'9". I'm going to exclude obese men, because I'm sure you don't want an obese guy. And let's just say they need to make at least 100K a year. Let's see what the probability of you finding that person in America that's non-married. You have a 5.6% chance of meeting a man that is unmarried, of any race, that's at least 5'9" or taller. He's not obese, and he's making six figures a year.
The divorce because you don't like him.
Yeah, I fell out of love with him. I think we just went to
okay, but
ways.
Do you have any children?
No, thank God.
Well, and you've been with him since how old?
Since I was 18, but we got married at 20.
All right, and what do you think's waiting for you out here?
New possibilities.
That's one way to frame it.
You know, we can probably be the best of friends. I just think we outgrew each other.
That's fine. You know? That's fine.
He's ready for kids. I'm not ready for kids.
All right. So I don't really see it's a disagreement here. You want to divorce your husband because he wants kids and you don't want kids? That's fine. But for somebody who's been married for nearly half your life, what do you want from a man in this world?
Well, a man of character, integrity, someone that I can grow with.
What do you want from a man in this world?
Love.
You have
I want love. I want companion.
You had that.
But you make it seem like people can't outgrow each other.
Well, ma'am. Stop right there. Stop right there. I didn't make it seem like a damn thing. I said you had that. And it's your responsibility as a wife to keep it going.
And it's also a husband, too.
It is. See, that. Thank you. Do you guys hear this? This is the problem that tends to happen in our relationships. It's 50-50 instead of 100. Did you do your 100% best to make sure that your marriage and your relationship lasted?
Yes, my husband wanted me to stay home. I figured like since I went to school, I worked hard for my degree and my career. Why should I have to give it up, especially when I don't have any kids?
Okay. So your husband wanted you to stay home, and you wanted to go to work.
Yes. So, my father raised me to
hold on. Listen. Listen. Then you're giving up a husband for possibilities in the world in your career. Okay. Hope you get what you want.
My daddy told me I'd be just fine. My father said that.
Well, here's the thing. How old is your father?
My father is 60.
Right. And got news for you. Your dad cannot guarantee that. That's nothing a father can guarantee a child.
And
you can say your dad can tell you whatever, but I'm going to tell you right now, you're just a woman, just like I'm just a man. You're one person out on the planet. And if you want to deal with any man out here, you're going to have to meet his needs, especially if you want a man that's higher level than you are. This independent street, this daddy's girl shit ain't going to play.
Well, Kevin, I work. I'm a nurse.
Congratulations. That matters.
I work with a lot of doctors.
You
say that a man don't care about a woman's money or career.
No, we don't.
And that's far from the truth, though.
Okay.
But that's far from the truth.
All right. All right. So you're telling me, all right, ladies, I want you to pay attention. This woman has been married, and she's telling me, as a man who's out here who have clients of these men, you act like you at 31 know better than me at 51. And I'm telling you, men don't care like you think we care. But guess what? You're going to get a chance to test this out on your own. Remember the women I said high-value men tend to avoid? And the nurse was in this category? It's not for just to take shots at nurses. It's the personality and the mindset that tends to come along. This independent da-da-da-da-da-da-da. All right. But in the end, ma'am, make your choices. But at the end, if you want something with a man, you're going to have to compromise.
Oh, I agree with you, but you making it seem like that.
I didn't make it seem like anything. Make it seem like what?
You're just making it seem like, oh, you're so bad. You know, like, especially for the young, you know, women in my age group that's not married, you know,
man,
there's hope. There's hope.
You're responsible for what you hear.
And you're responsible for what you put out.
No, you're responsible for what you hear. And you make it seem like women are so... No, I think that a lot of you women just don't listen. You listen with your feelings and you hear what you want to hear. And that's fine. But you're going to get to test all your theories. You got married at 18 or 19.
No, I got married at 20.
Okay, split the difference. You're going to get to test all these theories. In 10 years... we'll see who ends up being closer to accurate. But if you want anything from men, do you ever want children?
I don't know.
All right. So do you even want to, be married to a man?
Of course I do. I believe in love. I believe in marriage.
But that's not the purpose of marriage. Love is not the purpose of marriage. And you
marriage
already had
is
that.
A partnership.
All right. All right. All right. Round and round this goes. Oil, petulant children. Just, I want love. I want this. I want that. Women from other countries listen to Western women and think you're insane. This woman won early on.
Fellas, you ever hear women say, "I am single by choice"? It doesn't make any sense. Trust me, I know. By the end of this video, you'll know the truth behind women who say they're staying single by choice. So, the man she desires doesn't want her. She can't find men who earn enough for the lifestyle she wants while still having to work and pay significant bills. This woman is average at best, and the men she thinks she can get when she steps out with her BBL, lip injections, breast implants, excessively long lashes, Japanese cherry blossom body spray, everyday waist trainer, lace front, double chin, and French manicure only care to increase her body count. Be cautious of women who are self-improving. They will continue to bust it open. Once she's qualified for you, she'll have her preferred sex position, flowers, restaurants, deal breakers, and at least 10,000 followers. So, translation. I'm slutting till Mr. Right comes. See you on the next one.
You're the one that I like.
So I'm asking you, since this is not a demonstration of a man, you need to tell me what man you're using to measure him with. Which one?
My idea.
Which is your idea.
Mm-hmm.
Now, is that the idea you trained him up to be?
No.
Oh.
No.
Oh.
No.
Oh. So how in the blazing bejesus are you holding him accountable to a standard that you didn't teach him, he don't even know what it is, and yet as his mother, you sit in his face and tell him you don't respect him as a man? Tell me how that works.
Also, how he treats me.
Yeah, but you see, you are a provocative victim. You are a provocative victim. You are a provocative victim. You provoke stuff, and then when you start being held accountable for it, then you start twisting and turning and making the other person wrong, You just sat here and told your son, who I'm assuming pays his own rent, he's married to a registered nurse, he's got 3 baby boys, and you just sat here in his face and said, I don't respect him as a man.
So let's break this down for a second. She tells her son that has moved on, has 3 kids, is married, and she turns around and says, he's not man enough, or he's not a good man. Why do you think she said that? Most likely, it's simply because he left his mother. I'll say it again. He left his mother. See, a stable household where there's a mother and a father, the parents teach and train and raise their children to leave their parents, to go on with their lives, to start their own family. But in most cases, when there's a single mother there and there is no man, there is no father, the only thing she does is train her child to stay with their mother. And when that child actually goes off and leaves their mother, the mother actually feels betrayed. So most likely, this is what's going on in this situation. He's left the nest, went and got married, has 3 boys, is a good father. What's the problem? Problem is, he's not with his mother anymore. And she has a problem with that because most single mothers do not train their children to leave them. This is what men do. Men train their children to leave them because that's exactly what parenting is. Teaching your children how to leave the nest, not to stay in the nest or take care of the nest or grow up and be the husband of the nest. No, we make our own nest somewhere else. So this is the problematic behavior of a single mother, especially when she has a son. She essentially raises her son to take care of his mom when he grows up, not to grow up and take care of a family of his own, but to take care of his mother. And when he doesn't do that, he's less of a man. And this is the specific reason why fatherhood is so important. But guess what? None of your kids will ever experience that because you chose to be a single mother, because you chose to not get married before having a child.
And you don't think to consider what that does to his heart, to his soul, to his spirit.
I'm sure that's hurtful.
And you okay with that?
And it's hurtful for the things that he said.
You see what she said, right? I know that's hurtful, but what about me? I raised him. That's what she's saying. He abandoned me. I raised him all of his life. I was the only one there, and he turns around and abandons me for this woman. That's what she's saying.
But there you go. You're doing it. You're doing it right now. Holding you accountable and you spinning your web. Tell me.
Forgive me. I respect him. He's a wonderful man.
Do you understand that your mouth, your voice, your words are connected to the coils in his heart? He can't help but love you. And every time you dishonor that love, you chip a piece of it. This is why when the boys turn a certain age, the men come and get him and take him away from the mother, because she can emotionally manipulate him. We tear our men down and then wonder why they don't make good husbands and fathers. Mothers destroy sons. His mother can speak to him in certain ways that destroy him in ways that can never be repaired.
Average women have the equivalent sexual pull as a male celebrity. So an average woman, if she was so inclined, could sleep with a new guy every single night of the week. She could probably sleep with 2-3 guys a day. In order for a guy to be able to do that, you are less than the top 1% of men can do that. You have to have more than just good looks as a guy to do that. You need status. I think, honestly, only men with status can do it. What's that?
High value.
No, when I say status, I mean like celebrity, athlete, musician. These are the kinds of men that can like really run through chicks. But like an average chick could basically have the same sexual pull as like a top tier dude. Really top tier dude. Average guy working at Starbucks. Bro, no.
He ain't getting laid.
That shit is easy for you guys. Do you disagree? I mean,
the dam that collapsed in Alaska, it was the size of a small city. Who's going to repair that?
Women can't repair things now? Women architects.
Let's don't start talking about what they could do if they got serious about it. Let's talk about how your real world operates right now.
Just got
I'll do you one better. So I'm glad you brought that up. So you said women could do it if they needed to, right?
If they wanted to.
Okay. Do you agree right now that women are freer than they have ever been in life?
Absolutely.
Okay. Thank you. So if women are freer than they have ever been in life, you've had access to all of the resources, investors, contractors that men utilize to build this world. For the last 70 years, you've had access to all of the things that men utilized to build this great luxury of yours. Now, with all of that access, I need you to name one thing of significance that we utilize in our everyday life that was built by a woman.
Are you? Oh, my God.
Don't. Oh, my God. Just give me an answer.
There's many things that women
use. Stop deflecting. Just give me an answer. I know what deflecting is.
You know what? I'm sorry. Say that again.
Just give me an answer.
There's many things that, are you saying women have never?
Ma'am, I'm asking you to give me an answer. If you ask me, I could give you answers. I could say this platform that you're on right now. So literally, give me, you're deflecting, ma'am, and everybody knows
I'm deflecting.
It. You're
I'm
buying asking, time to I'm come not, up with a song.
What I'm asking you is, do you think women have never invented?
Ma'am, I asked you to name the inventor and to name the thing of significance that we utilize in our everyday life that was built by a woman.
So women don't build anything. Women just don't know how to build. Women don't make anything, don't invent anything.
Everybody sees that you can't answer this question. You're buying time to think is what you're doing.
Because I can't answer the question, I don't know who.
Flip the script and ask me what men have done.
That's not my perception. That's not what I do.
Okay, well, flip the script and ask me what men have done.
Why would I? I know that men have.
No, you don't want to do that,
sir.
So, and you just made my point.
Can I get a word in?
You made my point. You said women could if they this and that, but yet, right now, over the last course of 70 years, you've admitted you guys have had access to all the tools, but
and we haven't done anything with it.
Ma'am, I'm asking you to name it.
The prenup is a pretty one-sided thing.
Okay, so I guess we draw one up and then we figure it out. Have my attorney send it to yours.
But my question is, why do we really need one?
I've had a pretty large company even before I met you. So if we get married and then you decide to divorce me next year, then you leave with half of it, that's not fair.
But why are you already thinking about that?
Babe, it's something that I have to think about. I don't know why Danny's so surprised. The prenup's obviously something that we need to have in place. I built a business long before she even came into the picture, you know, and I have to protect that. Like, you want to get married? I'm, like, trying to work with you.
I don't want to be emotional. I'm just not sure if you're doing this because you don't trust me or, like, you're not sure about our future.
Well, I think you're overthinking it.
I don't know how to explain this to you. I feel like you're not understanding what I'm saying.
I am understanding. It's not my intentions to leave you. I hope that's not your intentions.
It's not. Like, I didn't even think about that. You're the one thinking about that.
It's just the reality of what makes sense, like.
Yeah, but it's like, this is like really this is not how I pictured, like, it was gonna start.
There's no reason to cry.
I need like 1 second.
Babe, you don't have to cry. Babe, really?
I just never thought that I'd get to a point where Don would make me feel like I'm just in that contract that needs to get signed. Hit on my face.
Damn.
I don't want to feel like a business. I don't want to feel like a transaction. Marriage shouldn't feel that way, you know?
You're being ridiculous.
I've worked really hard for a lot of years to build my company, build my assets.
Even before me and Danny started dating, my net worth was already, you know, multi-millions. And as me and Danny have been dating, I'm worth a lot more now, like millions more. And I have to protect it just in case, hey, worst case scenario, something doesn't work. And me and Danny have to part ways.
It definitely sucks to see her cry and be hurt about it. But
I just can't hand, you know, half of it away, regardless of how much I love her. It's just business. I'm trying to work with you, but all I ask is for you to work with me.
The way that I'm feeling right now, it's like I'm not valuable just because, like, I don't have money.
That's not what it is.
Well, that's the way it makes me feel.
Babe, it comes from the simple fact that I've had an established business and assets before I met you.
But, you know, technically it's a business that I poured into, too.
I mean, yeah, you helped, but, I mean...
I don't want to see Danny hurt, and I definitely appreciate everything she's done for my business, but these emotions are kind of throwing me off a little bit because I feel like I'm trying to get cornered into her trying to make me not sign a prenup.
I wish women really understood nowadays how horrible we present ourselves on social media and publicly when it comes to conversations about money and men making money. It blows my mind. Whenever I come across a post on social media of a woman who announces her pregnancy and she's pregnant by like a rapper, like a pro athlete or something, and there are thousands of comments from women under that post saying, God, please, when is it going to be my turn? Lord, please send me my millionaire. There are whole pages on TikTok and Instagram dedicated to teaching women how to sniff out millionaires and how to sniff out men with money. I just want to know, how do we get to this place collectively as women? Not, Lord, please send me a man of values, a man of morals, a man of integrity, a man who will commit himself to me, a man who will love me, honor me, respect me, a man who will be a good example for my children, a man who will lead my family properly. No, just send me a man who's a millionaire and I'm gonna figure the rest out on the back end. Imagine being a good man. Imagine being one of the men that I just described. A man who wants to find a wife, a man who is all of those things. And you go on social media and you're scrolling through the comments and this is what you see. This is what you have to choose from. This is what you see the mindset of modern women as. And then one of the most ridiculous responses to this that I've seen whenever women are challenged on these things, the response is always, well, half of the men who are worrying about it, they're broke anyway. They won't have to worry about a woman trying to use them for their money because they don't have any. That is not the point, sweetie. That's not the point. Your mentality as a woman, especially a woman who is considering having children or who has children, should not be financial status first, integrity, character second. It is so sad to me how the modern dating market and the overall tone of the modern dating market is that of entitlement and what's in it for me. People place way too much emphasis on financial status. And there's nothing wrong with wanting a partner who is financially stable. There's nothing wrong with wanting security. But when you are placing monetary gain over the very fabric of what a relationship is and a family foundation is supposed to be, you have got things very wrong and you really need to check yourself.
What can Black American women do to be saved / forgiven, or is it too late?
You mean like in mass?
Nothing. That's going to be done on an individual and very minute basis. You've unalived too many of our children. You've sent too many of us to prison. They've turned too many of our Black men. They've disrespected us too much in mass. They laughed at our death. They applauded a woman that said that they should abort Black male babies. They've done everything in their power to make themselves unattractive, i.e. fake hair, nails, and eyelashes. They've stolen our children away from us. They kicked us out of the house and contributed to breaking our family structure. They support and endorse musical artists that back the sentiment that we are replaceable. When it comes to how they dress, they bring our entire community to shame. They spend billions of dollars more money than black men do and have the nerve to talk about financial independence and freedom. And what, all of that's supposed to be done with an apology? As if. Nah, there's nothing that they can do in mass. This is why the Most High said he's going to destroy 2/3 of us. If there are more black women than black men, who is the majority of people that are going to be destroyed? Yep. I mean, I would sort of make the claim that black men have forgiven them and we still want to date them and we marry them at a rate of 80%. But save them? Oh, see, now you're talking about protection. And masculine heterosexual black men and even homosexual black men are waking up to the realization that all black women don't deserve protection. And we can't be shamed out of that. No matter of, oh, you don't protect black women is going to make us say, yeah, you know what? I should start protecting all black women. Those black men don't protect black women to begin with. If anything, they fight them. Just calling it like we see it. Not to mention they abandon them as well. And by abandon them, I simply mean that they have denied black women the thing that most black women will want at some point in time in their life around their 30s, which is a family. That particular lifestyle just doesn't permit that. So when pandemonium, chaos, and destruction comes to our shores, black men will more than likely bind together and only protect those women that believe in traditional values and want to be wives. Now ask yourself, how many black women out here want to be that? And by wannabe, I don't just mean they can verbally state it. I mean, they show us through their actions by being submissive, fit, feminine, friendly, cooperative, loving, caring, nurturing, and kind. Very few. And of those, most of them have children already. They're not desired as much as they would be if they were childless and all of those things. And black men don't want to save that, and we don't want to harm it either. So we'd rather the third option, which is wait till our God come back and make it perish. And then that way our hands can be clean of that blood. Black women would have to ostracize those women that do not want to be wives and en masse start adopting those mannerisms and characteristics that are worthy of them being wives to us. And we all know until they see a black man that cracked the sky open and his face looked down on us with red eyes and fire in his breath, that ain't gonna happen. Bars. P.S. Watch how submissive they get then.
A few years ago, my oldest daughter had to take a DNA test for school just to figure out ancestry. During the DNA test, she came to me very, very sad because apparently me and her were not related. I was like, huh? When she told me this, I had to keep a straight face because the immediate shock was just wild. Then I decided to go with her to get a paternity test done. When we got the paternity test done, it was also concluded that I was not her father. At this point, I was shocked. I've had 4 kids with my wife and she was the oldest, and I needed to see how far this rabbit hole went. I told her to not let her mother know that we know this information, and then I went to my next oldest child. Not mine. I went to the one below that. Not mine. And then I decided to stop there because the youngest child is so young that this may directly affect them and they don't really understand what's going on anyway. So I didn't even want to go into that rabbit hole. But when I got the information, I immediately was like, let me go talk to my wife about this. So, like always, she didn't take responsibility or any type of accountability. And she said, how are you going to believe your wife over these tests? I was like, are you serious? Are you like, for real, for real? Like, is this really where you're gonna go with this? Then she starts crying profusely and saying it was only one time. I didn't mean to do it. And I was like, it was only one time. Hey. And then I showed her that each one of the children aren't mine, with the exception of the youngest, as so I think. That's when it dawned on me that it was one time, multiple times. And then when we looked, each one of the children had different baby fathers. And somehow that made it even worse, because it wasn't just one person you was cheating on me with. This is a habitual thing with multiple different people that you probably don't know about. And I'm taking care of their kids. They're my kids. I've raised each and every one of them from a super young age, and they stood by me through this whole situation. But to think that she's not who she said she was, because up into that situation, I thought we had a great marriage. I thought we had a great life. I thought everything was going good. I thought that we were building together and already have built together. She is a stay-at-home mom that works on things that she wants to do. She takes care of the kids. She cooks. She cleans. She does everything that's needed inside of the relationship with me. Yet, she didn't tell me that she wanted to go outside of the marriage. She didn't tell me that she wanted to do anything. Anyway, after finding out the information and getting her side of the story, I let her know I would need a couple of space. So I had rented a hotel for a couple of days and I stayed in it. I stayed away and it was all right. It was good, but I really missed my kids and I wanted to see them. So after a couple of days, I was back inside of the house, but I'm not even gonna lie. I didn't say anything to my wife. I didn't speak to her. She would try to talk to me and I would look away. I would take care of the kids. I would grab the kids, take them to the mall, do different things with them. And everything was just, I was just trying to figure things out. I was just trying to see how I could make our relationship work or see if I need to separate and just take the kids myself. Like, I didn't know what to do if I had any like legal rights to these individuals. Yeah, my name's on the birth certificate, but I'm not biologically theirs. I just wanted to figure things out, but I didn't even get that chance. Because 6 days ago, she decided, other than taking any type of responsibility, to have a hangout session with the chandelier. And I'm so happy I have my kids because I just don't know what I would, like, it's just baffling to me. Because the whole time, even with evidence, she just kept denying and denying and denying and denying. And I don't know if I did something wrong. I don't know if I was never supposed to know in the first place. I don't know what's going to happen, but I know I didn't want this to happen. I didn't want to not have my kids, not to have their mother.
Another question. Married men, should you be asking your wife or children to take DNA tests? It's so offensive, but at this day and age, you probably need to. And because there's too many Nicki Minaj's, Megan Stallion, Cardi B's out there doing everything they do all up on this fans only Cash App, whopping, popping, snapping, tapping, booty, booty, booty. They throwing it out there, bro. A husband should somehow work his way around, I don't know, swab her mouth. You know, stick your finger in her mouth and then put it on a Q-tip and go take a DNA test and then tell them to match it with the kids. That way she won't even know. But you need to find out, man. No man wants to spend his whole life in deep love, going to work every day, supplying the needs of his woman, giving her his everything, and then find out she was giving her everything to someone else and all that you have is not even yours. Ooh, baby. The audacity for a woman to be in a marriage, pinning the kids on a husband, but out slinging Kudaket with men in the streets. She was so hurt by him finding out that she committed suicide on a chandelier, from what he was explaining. There are no words for this, people. Just have some love in your heart. Have some respect and kindness. Why would you hurt someone to this degree? She should have gotten out of that marriage a long time ago. Ooh, it makes people like me wonder if I should ever say those words I do again. People are so harsh and so cruel. Do you have any kindness in your heart? You're just out having babies and pinning it on him. He's paying for the kids, sleeping with you every day, kissing you in your mouth. But behind his back, you're out starting a whole new bloodline and lineage that he thinks is his, but it is not. Ain't no telling who the baby daddies are, man. That's, ooh, what a cold world we live in.